Are you frustrated not knowing why users are dropping off from your product? Well, Session Replay in Amplitude is a fantastic resource to help tackle this specific problem. In this video, I'm gonna guide you through three simple steps on how to set up Session Replay for Amplitude with Segment.com, and we're gonna do it through Google Tag Manager. So this is kind of like perhaps one of the most complex ways of doing this. And after we do this, you're gonna be able to fix some pain points, boost engagement, and feel confident in your product success. Now, this entire video is the product of a recent message I received from a client of mine. So let's jump in and see how I actually help a client accomplish all of this. So this client wanted Session Replay. This is a relatively new feature for Amplitude. It's included in all the pricing plans. There's just different levels, how many sessions you can record. And this is basically the equivalent of like a hot chart or a full story. You can actually see the sort of mini videos that show you how users are engaging with your product. So kind of as the pages load, they click buttons and things like that. However, to get this going, you do have to go and implement the Session Replay plugin that Amplitude offers. Is an extra additional step. Now, the stack for this client is, of course, Amplitude, but they're loading it through Segment.com, and they're using Google Tag Manager to manage a lot of the client-side or JavaScript tracking. So kind of we have to make all of it work. If you just have Amplitude, it's a little simpler, but if you add a little more steps, it's more complex. But let's start by understanding the actual plugin itself. So this is the Amplitude documentation. As always, you know, we have the different Session Replay plugins. So this is just the standard one, the browser SDK. So if you're using Amplitude directly, this is likely what you're going to be using. It's relatively pretty straightforward from a JavaScript perspective. It's almost like adding a little snippet. They have the standalone SDK, which means that this will be the option if you're using anything other than just Amplitude. So if you're using segment.com or anything else, this will be that. Then there's an option for Google Tag Manager. Because Google Tag Manager doesn't support the latest JavaScript, what's typically called as ES6. So a lot of the code samples you see are typically in ES6, but they need to be rewritten for an ES5, so they are compatible with Google Tag Manager. And then they have a special one just for Router Stack, which is just a competitor to Segment.com. So we are actually going to be combining these two. So we have to use the version that makes sense for Segment.com, but we have to make it compatible with Google Tag Manager. So it's a little bit more intricate, but you get to see how a lot of different pieces kind of come together. So it's going to be a little bit more helpful. All right. So I have a basic Google Tag Manager container and a segment account and an Amplitude account I use just for testing purposes. It's just actually loading on my website, rubenjarto.com. Nothing fancy. You can see it's a very simple container. All I'm doing right now is actually just loading the core segment.com snippet. Here's a JavaScript, right? We're loading the API key here dynamically, and then we fire a page view. So again, very basic. So to get this going, we first have to load the Session Replay plugin. So I'm going to show you the code and explain how the code works so then you're able to replicate it on your own. So we're going to create a custom HTML tag. We're going to call this the Amplitude Session Replay plugin. And in here, I'm going to paste the code. Okay, so here we have the code. Now, the first thing we have to do is we have to kind of load the Session Replay plugin. However, the code samples that Amplitude will give you are typically ES6, but as we mentioned before, Google Tag Manager does not support a lot of the ES6 languages. So anything like a const, like a C-O-N-S-T, the arrows, those are not supported at all. So we have to write a bit of code here to change how scripts load. So this is basically what this kind of first little bit is. And then we can then load the actual plugin itself here. Here's the line itself, right? And then we can initialize it here. So once we can initialize it, then we can just simply pass on a few things. Now, the first thing we have to pass on is we have to pass on the Amplitude API key. So I already created this right here, API keys. So you're simply loading the API key for the specific project. If you have a production or staging project, you may just look at lookup table, so they load depending on what environment you're working on. Pretty simple to do. Then we need a device ID. So typically, Amplitude manages a device ID. It's some kind of a randomly generated ID. However, because we're loading this through Segment, Segment manages the device ID for us. And in the Segment world, the device ID is actually the anonymous ID. So we have to go get it. So let's see if we can save this for now. We're not going to add a trigger yet. Let's instead go create a variable where we can go get the segment.com anonymous ID. Same thing, I'm gonna go grab some code. So we're gonna do this. So very basic, right? So there is a special function we can call that's called analytics.user.anonymousid. And then we get it. And then we do a bit of kind of logic just to make sure that we have something, otherwise it passes null. But again, this is generated by segment automatically. So it's unlikely to be null unless segment has not loaded. So I'm gonna save that. Now we're also gonna need a session ID. Same thing, typically Amplitude manages the session ID. This is given to every user. And then when there's 30 minutes or more of inactivity, then the new session ID gets generated. Pretty standard concept all the way back from Google Analytics. But Segment will manage this for us. So Segment has some logic to generate the session ID. And just like before, if there's some amount of inactivity, it creates a new one and so forth. So let's get it as well. So we're gonna do a segment.com session ID. Just like before, we're gonna do JavaScript. And here we go. Just like before, this is how Segment actually recommends you get the session ID. So it stores it in the local storage and it's called the analytics session ID underscore all of it. And we do the same thing as before. We just want to make sure this is not null. But again, as long as Segment is loaded, there will be a session ID that is being provided. So we're going to save these two. And let's go back to our tag. Oh, not this one. This one. And we're going to replace here the device ID with the anonymous ID. And we're going to call this the session ID. So a couple of things in the initialization that we have to note. Sample rate just simply means how many, what percentage of sessions will be captured for session replay. Typically, if we're testing, we're going to use one. If you're not testing, you have to use something smaller. So 0.1 means 10% of all your sessions will be recorded. Depending on how much traffic you have, this may be a way smaller number. So you want to check how many session replays are available in your plan. I think the free plan is something like 3,000 or 5,000 session replays per month. And then based on how much traffic you get, then you kind of figure out a number that makes sense. Obviously, once you hit your limit, Amplitude is not going to display them, but you probably want to find something here that's reasonable. And then debug mode will be true, of course, in development, and false in production. So now we are loading the session replay in a Google Tag Manager friendly way. Then we need to find a way to append the session replay ID. So the whole reason why we load the session replay is because Amplitude is going to generate an ID that's called a session replay ID. And then we need to append that to all the segment events, all the track calls that we're passing. And then once segment has it, then it's able to flow into Amplitude. And this is how then Amplitude is able to tie all the session replay data. My understanding is actually Amplitude receives the session replay data directly, and then it uses the ID to then actually show it and connect it in the interface itself. I think that's kind of what's happening behind the scenes. So to do this, we have to use what's called a middleware the Segment offers in the JavaScript SDK. A middleware simply means it's a piece of code that you enable, you create, and then every single payload that goes to Segment kind of stops at this middleware. It goes through any logic inside the middleware, and then it goes on to Segment. So as the name implies, it sort of takes place in the middle between when the payload is created and when the payload is delivered to Segment. Again, this code in Segment's documentation typically is ES6 friendly, but we need to make it ES5. So we have to kind of rejig it all. So in here, what we're going to do is we take every payload here, and then the next is just the payload that's going to go after. We're going to go get the session replay properties. So once we initialize the plugin, then we have the ability to run a function like this, which is going to give us the replay ID. And then if the payload itself is a track, then we're going to combine any of the existing event properties in that payload, and we're going to merge them with the session replay properties down here. So that's kind of what we're doing here. If the payload is not a track, it could be a page type payload for page views. It could be an identify. It could be a group. Then we're not going to do anything. And then once we're done, then we simply put on the modified payload, the one that has been merged with both the existing event properties and the session replay properties, and we're going to send it on to Segment. Again, this is all the middleware does, which is kind of created, and then it's going to work on its own. We don't have to do anything else. Once we do all that, then we can actually load the middleware into Segment. Again, this is also our GTM-friendly code. If you look at the documentation Segment, it's going to look drastically different, probably much more condensed, because ES6 JavaScript is typically pretty small, easy to kind of work with. And then just going to test it all. We're going to fire a simple event called test event, with one event property called video, and this is gonna be the value for it. So in our testing, we should be able to see this one existing event property plus any other session replay properties and segment that's added on top of that. Okay, so we're gonna save this. Now, we do want some kind of trigger. So what we're gonna do is segment has a very handy function called analytics.ready. So I'm gonna show that to you here. So in the core snippet, I'll just go ahead and add a very simple code here. So analytics.ready, as you can imagine, fires when segment has fully finished loading. So when this happens, we're gonna push an event into the data layer called analytics.ready. And this is just simply gonna then allow us to create a trigger. The reason why we want this is, remember, right, to initialize the session replay plugin, we need the anonymous ID and the session ID from segment, which means segment needs to have finished loading. So we don't wanna do any kind of funky things in the tag itself. There's a couple other ways you could do this, but I kinda like this because it kinda works quite well. Once we, you know, we have this analytics ready, we can then go and choose a custom event right here. I'm gonna call this just DL analytics ready. So now we have this trigger that we can use anywhere else we want. And analytics ready actually gets used quite a bit. Okay, so now I think we have everything we need to test. So we're loading the session replay plugin. We got the keys, device ID, session ID. We're in debug mode, so it's one and true. We get the middleware. We got our test event and everything's good. Okay, so let's go test this. So we are going to go test this on my website, and I do have a special URL. Very simple sort of data tool testing page. There's a blank page on my website. Let's go into GTM first. Okay, so here's GTM. So everything looks okay so far, you know? So we have our one page, we load a segment, the session replay fired. Here's actually the analytics ready event that we fired from this one, if you remember. That's kind of nice. So the session replay fired there, nice. If you look at the variables itself, here we go. So we have the session ID that we get from segment, and we have the anonymous ID right here that we're also getting from segment. Great, no problem there. So let's go into a page. Things are looking good so far. Let's go into a console and let's see if session replay is here. Okay, so it's there. And if we actually look at session replay, get session replay properties right there. Great. So there is the session replay ID that we want. This debugger is only on the debug level, so it actually will not be in production, but this is kind of what we want. So now the middleware is supposed to be taking all this and adding it to any track calls. So let's go into segment, see what we had there. So here's our segment debug for this JavaScript source I have. So we have the page loads, okay, that's okay. And then we have this test event. Remember, we had a special test event. And it had the one property we added called video with just session replay for Amplitude, just for fun. And then here we can see that the middleware added the two properties from the session replay properties. Again, this debug is only here because we're debugging. It will not be in production. And really what we care about is the session replay ID, which is being added. This does mean that if we were to just do another test event, so if we go into our testing page again, and we remove these two, again, and we fire just this basic event, right? It fires. And we go see the second event here, segment, and the middleware then adds it again, right? So the middleware is adding all the stuff that we need automatically for us. So now let's go to see the final step, which is Amplitude. So to see Amplitude, let's go find the anonymous ID that we have for this user right here. And we're gonna go look for this user in Amplitude. So this is Amplitude. It's a test project, of course. I don't really have that much data, but we can narrow it down here. We can take that ID we just search. We'll go find it in here. We have our test event. Actually, we have both test events here, which is nice. They both have the session replay ID. And we have here the session replay that actually we were just doing. You can see it's actually quite long as I was kind of recording this video. But then the session replay is kind of built around it, right? Pretty simple. It's all set up. And this is then how you get session replays going in Google Tag Manager, Segment.com, and Amplitude. Thank you for watching. My name is Ruben Garta. I'm an expert in MarTech. This is just one of the many things I do on a regular basis with clients all over the world. And I'm always excited to kind of bring some of these use cases down for you and kind of see you step by step on how you can do this on your own. If you're serious about making your Amplitude data work harder for you, I highly recommend you check out this 49-minute video I recorded on how to make your Amplitude data smarter by implementing it correctly. So it covers all the critical points that you must keep in mind if you're thinking about using Amplitude. Even if you already implemented Amplitude, I still highly recommend you check it out, as there may be a few points you may have missed that are limiting the insights you might get from this tool. It'll show you how to unlock more insights, boost engagements, and conversions. So the video will appear here, and I hope you get the most out of it. Until next time, we'll talk soon.